Hello friends, this is me Monica Sharma and welcome to MS Bio Academy. And today we are going to talk about the antigen processing and presentation by MHC class 2 molecules. This is the part 2 of the video. In the part 1 we have discussed about the antigen processing and presentation by MHC class 1 molecules. So let's begin today's topic and start it. So what are MHCs? MHCs, we know these are the major histocompatibility complex, as I have told you many a times, and these are basically being coded by the group or the cluster of genes which are present on the chromosome number 6 in case of humans, and if you talk about the rat, it is in chromosome number 17, right? So these are basically coding for the proteins which are the MHCs, and they are found on the cell surface. What is the role of the MHC? They help the immune system or the immune cells in recognizing the foreign substances. So basically they are helping in presenting all these antigens or the pathogens or the foreign substances so that it can be recognized by the immune cells, right? And there are two types of MHCs, class 1 and class 2. In this particular video we are going to talk about the MHC class 2 antigen processing and presentation. So MHC-II expression, we know that it is being expressed by all the antigen presenting cells, right? So the main antigen presenting cells, if you know, there are the three main professional antigen presenting cells are the macrophages, the dendritic cells and the B cells. They are mainly the phagocytic cells, and they mainly recognize, they are going to internalize mostly the exogenous antigens, right? So those antigens which are, or those pathogens which are present outside the cell, these APCs, since they have a phagocytic nature, they are going to phagocyte or eat up these exogenous antigens, and then these exogenous antigens will be presented to the T helper cells. So in short, we can say that the class 2 molecules, they are going to present the peptides or the antigens to the T helper cells, while we have studied the class 1 is presenting the antigens to the TC cells, or you can say the CD8 positive cells, right? And class 2 to the CD4 positive cells, right? So this you have to remember, because most of the questions comes on this, that class 1 is going to present the antigens to which type of T cells, whether TC cells, T helper cells or any other cells, right? So this you have to remember this, right? And mostly the class 1, they are going to present the endogenous antigens, while the class 2, they are going to present the exogenous antigen. This is also important difference between both of them, and this also you need to remember, because mostly questions comes on this, right? So just like the class 1, MHC-II molecules are also their assembly take place in the endoplasmic reticulum. Now all these process, how this antigen processing take place, now let's cover up with the help of a diagram. So let's suppose this is a typical cell, this is an antigen presenting cells, or you can say APC, and there is an exogenous antigen outside. Okay, so this is a pathogen. So what they are going to do, since we, I have told you that APC is mostly macrophages, dendritic cell, they are what? They are phagocytic cells. So they are going to eat up this pathogen, right? And they will engulf it inside them. So let me tell you with the help of diagram. So if this is a pathogen, they are going to phagocytose this pathogen inside, they are going to eat up, and then they will form this endosome, right? So this endosome then fuse with the lysosomes, and they will form endolysosome. So lysosome, after fusion with the lysosome, what it will do, it will going to release all its enzymes, the digestive enzymes inside the endosomes, and these enzymes then degrade this protein molecule into a smaller peptides, right? So smaller peptides will be released then, right? So till this stage it will be formed here. Now let's move on and talk about what the afterwards, how the assembly with the MHC-II molecules will take place with this peptides. So let's suppose the earlier part which I have shown you, that the formation or the degradation or the formation of the endolysosome, in which all these peptides are being now formed, which are of some, let's suppose, 10 to 15 amino acids long, right? So they are now being formed. Now coming back to the MHC molecule, as we say that they are also being assembled in the endoplasmic reticulum. So this is the endoplasmic reticulum, the rough endoplasmic reticulum, and this is the MHC-II molecule which is being assembled. Now here what will happen, during this assembly there is one invariant chain. This is the invariant chain which is come and bind to this groove portion of this MHC-II molecule, so that it won't allow this groove to being closed. Okay, we know that this is an open groove, right? Open groove here. So this is just because of the binding of the invariant chain in the endoplasmic reticulum. After this binding of the MHC-II molecule with the invariant chain, this will move out of the endoplasmic reticulum in the form of a vesicle. So here if I draw it, so this will come like this. So this is the invariant chain, right, which is bound to this groove portion of the MHC molecule. Now what will happen after this? This will fuse with the late endosome, and on fusion with the late endosome, there are certain enzymes which are present in the late endosomes which are going to break this invariant chain into a small peptide. Okay, so invariant chain is basically a polypeptide. So what the enzymes will do, it will break them into a small peptide, right? So let me draw for you here again. So if this is the MHC-II molecule and this is being broken down into a small peptide, now this small peptide of invariant chain is known as a CLIP, C-L-I-P. Now this CLIP stands for the class 2 associated invariant polypeptide. Now, after formation of this CLIP, what will happen? This vesicle, this endosome, it is going to fuse with this endolysosome which contain the peptides. Now, after this, what will happen? All these peptides which are present in this, they are going to displace. They are going to displace this in this CLIP portion, and they will occupy this position. So all these peptides, they are going to now occupy this groove, open groove portion of the which is earlier being occupied by the CLIP, right? So they are going to displace this CLIP and they will come and occupy this portion, right? Then afterwards, this will move out of the cell surface and they will release its internal content outside. So here you can see that this is being then expressed on the cell surface. This is the class 2 molecules which is being coupled with the peptide molecules. So this is how this is being come on the cell surface. So this is how the whole antigen processing part take place, and then this is being coupled with the MHC-II molecules, and this is the peptide, right? So this is the MHC-II molecule, and they are then come and present this peptide on the cell surface. Now let's talk about how the interaction with the T cells take place. So what will happen the moment this MHC molecule, this is going to present, or this is going to come on the cell surface with its peptide, right? These exogenous peptides, T cells, the T helper cells, they will come and their T cell receptor will recognize this peptide along with the co-receptor, that is the CD4 co-receptors, right? So this whole interaction of the T cell receptors, the peptides which is being presented by the MHC, and the CD4 co-receptor interaction with the MHC molecule, this will give a signal to the T helper cells, and T helper cells then get activated, and these T helper cells then release certain cytokines, the protein molecules outside the surface, which will in turn will activate the let's suppose the B cells. This will activate the B cells, and then B cells will differentiate into a plasma and memory cells. And we know that plasma cells, what it do, it will secrete the antibodies which are specific to this particular peptide, right? So they are going to secrete the antibodies which are specific to this particular peptide and will try to neutralize it. Or it would, these cytokines will attract all other immune cells to this particular area and will take in generate an immune response against this peptide. So this is how the whole response take place. You can also see that in this particular diagram. So this is a T helper cell, and this is the T cell receptor which is going to recognize this peptide presented by the MHC-II molecule, right? So this is B cell, which is the antigen presenting cell here, and it is presenting the peptide with the help of MHC-II molecules to the T helper cells, right? So then this will generate, activate the T helper cells, and they are going to release these cytokines. Okay, so these IL-2 and 4 and 5, these are the cytokines which are being interleukins, which are being released by the T helper cells, which are now recognized by the these B cells in turn, and this will then activate these B cells, and these B cells will start releasing these antibodies against this particular pathogen and will generate an immune response, right? So this is how the whole process, the antigen processing and presentation by means of MHC class 2 molecules take place. I hope this is clear to you guys. If you have any queries, please do let me know in the comment section below. So thank you so much guys. If you like my lesson, please do subscribe for my channel MS Bio Academy, and do share with all your friends. Bye for now.